How are you all? Hope you all are fine. Today, I am going to show you how to make a black forest cake. Black forest cake is everyone's favorite, but it is very easy to make. Let's get started. First, I am greasing the pan. This is a 7-inch wide and a 5-inch deep pan. Try to use little deep pan because finally the cake will rise well. At this time, I am preheating my oven at 180 degrees Celsius. Line it with a parchment paper and grease on top also. Into a large bowl, I am adding 1/2 cup melted butter, that is 120 ml. If you want, you can use sunflower oil also. Into this, I am adding 2 cups of powdered sugar, that is 400 grams. First, measure the sugar, then powder it. Add gradually and mix it. Now I am adding eggs. Total I am using 3 eggs. Add one by one and beat well. Adding 1 cup of milk, that is 240 ml, and it should be in room temperature. Into a sieve, I am adding 2 cups of all-purpose flour, 250 grams. 3/4 cup of unsweetened cocoa powder, 75 grams. 2 teaspoons of baking powder. 1 teaspoon baking soda. 1 tablespoon vanilla powder. Instead of vanilla powder, you can add 1 tablespoon of vanilla essence into the wet ingredients. I am not adding salt now because I have used salted butter. If you are using unsalted butter or oil, you can add a pinch of salt at this time. Gently mix with a spatula. Now beat it for just 15 to 20 seconds to remove the lumps. Don't beat more. Now transfer the batter into the greased cake tin. Tap it for a couple of times. Then bake it in the preheated oven at 180 degrees Celsius for 55 to 60 minutes. Always check after 45 minutes because every oven's temperature would be different. Meanwhile, I'm going to make the cherry syrup. For that, I used 1/2 cup of cherries and I'm chopping it. Into a saucepan, I am adding 1/2 cup cherry, 1/2 cup sugar and 1 cup water. Cook it until the water reduces to 1/2 cup. So the cake is baked well. The toothpick insert in the center came out clean. Now allow it to cool down completely. After that, we will assemble the cake. Now I am removing the top layer of the cake because this top part will be little hard, and if we remove the top part, we can level the cake. I am dividing the cake into 3 equal parts so that we can fill with frosting. I am going to keep the layered cake in the fridge for 1/2 hour so that when we do frosting, it will be easy. Now I am going to make the frosting. For that, I used a large bowl and I kept the bowl and the beating blade in the freezer for 1/2 hour. Adding 2 cups of whipping cream. This is 500 ml. I kept the whipping cream in the fridge for overnight, so it is very chilled now. Adding 1/2 cup of powdered sugar or icing sugar. And I'm going to beat it until I get a nice stiff peak. Always remember to keep the frosting cream in the fridge after beating it because it may start to melt if you keep it outside. Take a small portion into a separate bowl while frosting the cake. So now we will start to assemble the cake. Here I'm using a cake board. You can use any plate or your favorite thing. First, spread a thin layer of frosting on top of the board. Then I am going to keep the first layer. Soak it with cherry syrup and add some chopped cherries on top of this. Add a layer of frosting and spread it. Thank you. placing the second layer on top, and repeat the same process for this also. So I placed the third layer also and I soaked it. So don't add cherries on top of this because we are going to do the final frosting. Covering the sides. You don't need to do it very perfectly because finally we are covering the cake with the grated chocolates. I'm grating some chocolates to decorate the cake. Here I'm using my small blade of the grater. If you want, you can use a peeler also. So I have made some flowers on top of this. Actually, I missed to shoot that part. Nothing, you just fill the frosting in a piping bag with your favorite nozzle and make the flowers on top. Spread the grated chocolate carefully on top. The frosting looks little creamish in camera, but actually it is white in color. Gently spread the chocolate on sides also. Carefully clean the sides with a tissue paper, and I'm going to decorate the flowers with some cherries. So this is the final look of my cake. If you like this video, please share and subscribe to my channel. See you again with a new recipe. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.